Okay. Yeah. Mainly is under control, of the COVID.
Okay. Yes. I hope in the near future I can come to your country. After the the COVID-19. Anyway, before so free communication. Go around our country and your country. Until then, I will continue. This my talk. On this lecture. I record. I'm recording all my lecture. And save in the YouTube. And anytime you can see.
Yes.
Okay. So today.
Yes.
I'll talk about some tips of trochanteric fracture. So I will introduce a newest Japanese paper because in Japanese trochanteric fracture and femoral neck fracture in the hip fracture is very, very frequent and very popular because of too many patients. So many surgeons is focused on the hip fracture. Unlike your country.
Yes.
So your country is very, very a lot of the acute trauma, such as open fracture and comminuted.
Really.
But in Japan, traffic is very sophisticated. So severe fracture, the structure trauma is decreasing in times. But in in contrast, the very minor, the elderly fracture is increasing, hip fracture, and peri implant fracture after the arthroplasty or after the implantation, then the elderly patient fall down and have the fracture around the implant previously operated. So this is also serious.
Yes.
So anyway, I talk about the ligament around the hip.
Okay.
So please have a look.
Okay, Professor.
Okay,
Professor. Please carry on. Please carry on your presentation, and we are now listening, and later we have to discuss for you.
Okay.
Thank you, sir.
Anatomy. Can you see this picture of the hip ligament? Can you see? This one, iliofemoral ligament. So in Japan, this ligament is very, very focused on because it can decide the type of a fracture and the management of the fracture significantly. The previously, there are so many classification systems, such as Evans, Jensen, AO, but such classification system never consider about this ligament system. So this iliofemoral ligament have the two parts. This is a longitudinous fiber. This is from here to the just above the lesser trochanter. And another one is transverse. This is a longitudinal one and transverse one. This transverse one is end into intertrochanteric line just until to the greater trochanter. So this is relation is very important. So I will introduce the newest Japanese paper. So please wait. Oh, this one. This is the cadaver study, anatomical study. This one is a longitudinal one. This is a transverse one. They measured the length and thickness. And they concluded that this longitudinal fibers end at this side. So medial part of the intertrochanteric line and the transverse line is end at the upper side of in the trochanteric right. So in conclusion, there is a two part of intertrochanteric line. This is the lateral and the medial line. There is some space between them. So relationship, especially for the longitudinal one, is very important in terms of the insertion of these fibers and the fracture line. So this one, this is the Japanese surgeon. Is they classified into three types.
This is the no change.
Okay.
No change.
Oh, no change. Okay. Sometimes happened. Okay. Can you see this one? This is Japanese paper. Can you see? Oh, sorry. This one, okay. Oh, this is This is the insertion of the longitudinal fiber of the iliofemoral ligament, and this is the insertion. They classified into the three types. That this is a proximal one, and this is a distal one. So just at the insertion of the iliofemoral ligament. So if fracture line is proximal to the insertion of the iliofemoral ligament, the fracture can be very unstable. And if the fracture line comes to the distal to the insertion of the iliofemoral ligament, the fracture can separate due to the traction of iliofemoral femoral ligament. So they classified into three types and evaluated, compare the fracture loss, fixation loss between the three types. This is the P, means the proximal type. And this one is just at the insertion of iliofemoral ligament, and this is the distal one. But the proximal one is most unstable. This percentage means the total compression or shortening of fracture, the mean. So in the DD type, it's the fracture line count distal to the insertion of iliofemoral ligament. The shortening of fracture was up to 10%. It's very small. But proximal one, if the fracture come to the proximal to the insertion of the iliofemoral ligament, the fracture can collapse, the shorten up to 30%. What is the difference between these types? Because distal type is the fragment is very big. Even the distal end of the proximal fragment, the fracture end, the fracture fragment is very thick and very big. But on contrary, the P, the end of the fracture is come to the proximal to the iliofemoral ligament, the fracture proximal fragment is very thin and very fragile. So the stability is very not so good. So it can collapse, it can migrate into the distal fragment. So in addition, in Japan, we are very, very focused on the post-operative overlapping of the fracture. Okay, I will show you. Maybe Chanta already see this classification in the intramedullary type and the extramedullary type. Do you remember?
Yes. Okay. Yes.
Okay, I will show you. Please wait. Sorry, please wait. Okay, this one. Again, this is a very famous classification system.
No change.
Yeah, I know. Please wait a minute. I'm sorry. Please wait. Okay, I changed. Maybe I changed.
Okay,
this is the very, very famous classification system. And the before and after the reduction. Before the operation and after the reduction. So we are focused on the relationship of the anterior superior fragment here and the distal fragment. The relationship, if this proximal fragment comes anterior to the distal fragment, is stable. It can be stable because this bone fragment can hit impact to the distal fragment. It can get the stability between the fragment. This is also good reduction. So in the same level between the proximal and the distal fragment, but in the contrary, on contrast, if the proximal fragment come posterior to the distal fragment, so there is no bony contact. Only the contact between the cancer bone that should be very fragile, very weak. So impaction and migration never stop. Similarly, in another surgeon also classified into three types. This is the lateral view. Is lateral view if the proximal fragment counter anterior to the distal fragment, we call it is intramedullary type, this one. So proximal fragment can migrate into the distal fragment. So this is the anatomical type. It's the anterior cortex is the same level between the fragment. That is the extramedullary type. So distal fragment curve anterior to the distal one, so that can the both fragment can hit anterior cortex. After anterior cortex, they can get the stability. So we also focus on the ligament. So this one, this type should be the ligament come from here to here, the end of here. So, but it is sometimes difficult to reduct because of the traction of the iliofemoral ligament. So we sometimes try to detach this ligament from the distal side using some elevator. After that, this fragment can reduct to come near to the distal cortex level. In contrast, if the iliofemoral ligament is come here, the fracture line the proximal to this insertion of this ligament, so proximal fragment tend to come here. So in this situation, bone contact never occur, and oversliding migration compression occur. So relationship between the ligament and the fracture line is very important. So sometimes we try to reduce the fragments in the fracture, trochanteric fracture, simply traction and rotation. But it is sometimes failed, sometimes difficult to to reduct. So sometimes in this situation, I try to insert stain mapping or the thick K wire and push this fragment to posteriorly and try to redact this fragment.
And in as a joint stick, joint stick.
Sorry?
As a joint stick.
Joystick. Something the joystick. Joystick. Oh, this is joystick very well. This one is act the joystick very well. But this type we sometimes using the Kapanzi method, interfocal pinning. Yeah, please. So I will show you later. So this is a simple control to the alignment, the controlling the distal fragment using the nail and the targeted device. And another technique is this one, intrafocal pinning. So many Japanese surgeons hate this type of fracture. This is the intramedullary type. So this proximal fragment come distal posterior to the anterior cortex of the distal fragment. Then they try to insert the K wire in through the fracture site and then lift up the anterior cortex of the proximal fragment. Then insert lag screw. Oh, this is similar to the mini open method. Sometimes it is difficult to redact the intrafocal pinning. So at that situation, insert this elevator from the proximal one. So nail insertion wound or lag screw insertion wound. And control the proximal fragment. And anyway, to lift up the anterior cortex of the proximal fragment to the outside of the distal fragment. So after that, they can get a good bony stability due to the bony contact of the anterior, anterior cortex. So sometimes some surgeon devised this tool to reduction. So, this is the anatomy of the iliofemoral ligament. As I said before, there are the two parts. This is the longitudinal fiber, and this is the transverse fiber. So this one, the longitudinal one, insert at just above the minor trochanter, lesser trochanter, and the transverse one is end at just media to the media border of the greater trochanter. So relationship between, again, relationship between the insertion of the iliofemoral ligament and the fracture site is very important. This fracture line is distal to the insertion. It can lift up, jump up the anterior cortex. So we can sometimes see this situation after the reduction. So one idea to insert the elevator from the wound for insertion of the nail and insertion elevator here between the capsule and iliofemoral ligament and detach. So similarly, this is this situation. In this situation, insertion of the iliofemoral ligament is distal to the fracture line. That means the fracture line here in the above the insertion of the iliofemoral ligament, that can cause intramedullary type. In this situation, surgeon need to reduct the proximal fragment, lift up, and until the entire cortex of the proximal fragment and anterior to the distal fragment anterior cortex. So, but it is sometimes difficult due to the traction of the ligament. So also in this situation, so insert elevator and detach. After that, sometimes this fracture type of very, very difficult reduction fracture can reduct very easily. So we should focus on not only the location and the site of the fracture and the number of the fracture, but also the relationship between the ligament and fracture line. Okay, so, but even after the reduction of the fracture, this is the schema of the intramedullary type. This side is anterior, this is the side is the posterior, this is the proximal, and this is the distal. In the intramedullary type, the proximal fragment comes posterior to the anterior cortex of the distal fragment, then reduct using the focal pinning.
You can see presentation. So,
sorry?
You can see presentation.
Oh, you can see. You can't see. Okay. I'm sorry. Okay. Please wait a minute.
Yes, Professor.
Okay.
Hello, Professor.
Hello. Hey.
Hey, hello, Professor.
Hello.
yeah.
Okay.
So, what I want to know is, you have to highlight about the ligament around the hip.
Yeah.
But I want to know is, are you in favor of the proximal femoral nailing and your device? What's the difference between the proximal femoral locking and your device? Is your device very suitable for this fracture? And you already mentioned is you have to take care of the ligament stability. And so, okay, what about maybe, your implant?
Maybe an implant doesn't matter. Maybe
implant is not matter.
Matter, yes, because we can control this fracture through the hole to the wound for the lug screw.
Mm-hmm.
We can insert.
Yeah.
And please insert your finger from the wound for the lug screw, and you can feel the anterior cortex and both proximal and distal fragment. It is quite easy. This technique is only for the fracture that cannot be reducted, only the traction. Then sometimes we can insert with some displacement, but sometimes the displacement is very severe. So in addition, we recommend to reduct this intramedullary type to the extramedullary type because situation the fracture can tend to migrate and impact.
Yeah.
That can cause the shortening on the even the non-union or cut out.
Oh, okay. And for you,
reduction is very difficult due to the tension of the iliofemoral ligament. If after the traction, it is very difficult to reduct, please insert your finger and you can feel the iliofemoral ligament and detach.
Yeah.
After that, maybe the reduction is very easy, very clear. Even the detachment is not perfect because the insertion of ligament is wide, very wide, throughout the intratrochanteric line. So we can access only the part of the insertion of the iliofemoral filament, but even the partial detachment of the ligament, it should be enough. It is quite easy to reduct. So this is the one tip. So many surgeons, in Japanese surgeon, it try to reduct and get the perfect result. Because in Japan, it's very special situation. In the average age of the trochanteric fracture is between 85 to 90. Very, very old. Fracture is very, very fragile. So we need security, and we need get the secure fixation. So
he's
very, very nervous to get the good reaction. Yeah.
So for you, so for you, which device do you prefer?
Of course, I am nail.
Oh, really?
Yes. Because. Because I am nail is very popular in Japan, and unlike your country in Japan. Thanks to the very good insurance system,